Hey guys, welcome back to Million Beautiful Views, and today we're going to be doing this really pretty look. I was feeling gold and like a cobalt blue, so that's the swatches right there. I just picked two colors out and I just was like, let's go with it. Okay, so to get started, I'm going to go into my Juvia's Place palette, and I'm going in with like a deeper like burgundy, well, brown undertone of burgundy tone. And I'm just going to put it into my crease and I'm just going to swipe it back and forth and just to build that color up in my crease. Now, when I said I wanted to go gold and cobalt blue, I just was like, I don't know what colors I want to put in my crease. So just follow the tutorial and you'll see what I came up with. Okay, so then I decided that I was going to go in with a little bit of a like peachy orange tone. And I just wanted to kind of like brighten that up a little bit going towards my brow bone. So I'm just going to blend that in. I was so indecisive at this point. So I'm like, okay, let me just think while I'm blending. What do I want to do? And this is how realistic my tutorials go. When I start, I just go with the flow. So I'm just going to blend that in with the same brush. And of course, I used my brush like cleaner, like that's it right there, and that takes the color off my brushes. It's so good. Got it from Beauty Supply. So I decided to go in with like this cranberry like purpley tone. It was really pretty, and I said, oh my god, I need to use this more. And so anyway, so I just decided to like pop that into my crease right on top of that like brownie kind of like burgundy tone. It's more brown than burgundy, but I wanted it to like, I wanted the colors to pop a little bit more. I didn't want to go like flat brown in the crease. I wanted to like brighten it up a little bit. And normally like when I look at different tones, I'll just play with it and see like how I want everything to like correspond together. And in my mind, I'm like, okay, blue and purple goes really, really well together. So I just played around with tones just to like switch up the usual blue and gold type of eye. And you don't see that often. You don't really see like a purple cranberry color in the crease. So I'm like, this might be different and it might be cute. So I'm just going to blend that in a little bit more. And I would really want to bring that in a little bit. So when I cut my crease and with my concealer, then you can kind of like see it. So I'm going in with black in this Juvia's Place palette. And I just want to like smoke out that outer corner. And I'm just doing a little bit at a time because I didn't want it to be like super dark. And you know, sometimes with black, once you go, it's hard to take away. So I always go really light and then you can always add more later. So I'm just going to blend that in right on the outer V of my eye. And that's going to help smoke it up a little bit so it's not so flat. These are like the 99 cent wipes from Target. I decided to try these out and I like them. Like they clean up pretty well. Like you see, like that sharpened my line really well. Like all the fallout got cleaned up. And so if you need a cheaper alternative for some makeup wipes, these work very, very well. Like I was so surprised because I always go with like a brand, or I will go with like the Target. Like Target has like another brand. It's like, I think like $2 or $3. So I normally go with that one if I'm not sure which one I want to use, or I want something cheaper, like a cheaper alternative, I'll go with those. So these are like really cheap, 99 cent. You can't go wrong. And sometimes they even have a coupon in their cartwheel so you can get it even cheaper. So check that out if you're next time you're out at Target and just see if you like these. So I'm going in with my e.l.f. Camo Concealer. I always cut my crease with this. And I'm deciding to do like a half cut crease. So I'm just bringing that line really sharp into my inner corner. I really wanted my eye to like be pulled in and like kind of dramatic in a way. And this is like what I do to like open up my eye a little bit. And it really does help. Like if you feel like you want to like brighten it up and like open it up a little bit more, bring that line down a little bit more. I mean, you can even make it a little more sharper if you wanted to, but this really does like create like the type of shape of eye that you want. So this is like the perfect way to do it. So try it out. So I'm going to use my blending brush, and this is a two-sided dual brush, and I normally use this to flatten out and smooth out my concealer. So I'm going back with the same Juvia's Place palette, and I'm going to pick this gold. And with the swatch, when I was swatching the colors I wanted to use, I noticed that this gold was like really different. It almost had like a green undertone to the gold. It wasn't like your typical bright yellow undertone. And I said, okay, I want to just try this out and see. And green and blues go very well together. So I knew that this was going to blend really well. And it kind of switches up from that yellowy gold that I use all the time. So I was okay with it. And the payoff, as you can see, was amazing. Look at that. Like the shine on that, the opaqueness on it, like it's not super sheer. Like you get coverage. So I'm going in with this different Juvia's palette, and I'm going to put all the names of the palettes that I use down in the description, and I'll also tag the names of everything that I use on my Instagram also. So this blue right here, I've used this blue before. I'm very familiar with the payoff with this, but I'm just feeling like blue and gold, so I just knew that this was a good blue to go with. Juvia's Place is the like best makeup brand. Like the colors, the pigment, like it's just amazing. Like you really can't go wrong if you have not picked up a Juvia's Place palette before. Any of her palettes, it's amazing. That company is bomb. So just try it out this Christmas. Put it on your list. You can see right here, look at that blue next to the gold. It's literally bomb. Like, man. So I'm about to show you like my blending technique that I do when I'm using like opposite colors, or if I want to like do this like mirror blending effect when I do like two different colors and I want them to like gradingly go into one another. So I'm really placing that blue down directly next to it. Like you almost can see it. It's like split in half. And I'm sorry if you hear beeping in my background. So when I put that blue like right next to that gold, it doesn't matter if it like get over into the gold, because I'm going to show you it's going to blend anyways. Like this doesn't have to be perfect. You really just want to like make sure that color is there exactly how you want it to be. It's not streaky. It's full pigment all the way down. So I'm taking that gold, right? Y'all, when I found this out years ago, I kept doing it. Take the gold and you want to use one side with gold, one side with blue on a flat eyeshadow brush. You're going to blend that yellow over into the blue. And you're just going to keep moving that like color over. And it's going to naturally want to like flow into the color, the next color next to it. And you're just going to keep going back and forth. And you can go with the blue and blend some of that blue over to the yellow. Perfect. Like it's almost like a hack almost. It's so neat. Like at one point in the beginning of my like, you know, makeup, I did not know how to blend, and that was like the best thing I've ever tried. So I'm going in with my NYX matte liner, and I'm just doing like a more elongated wing. I wanted it to kind of show when I go to turn my head and everything. Like I wanted it, my eye to be like brought up to the sky. I wanted it to be like pulled, okay? I wanted it to be very, very nice and sharp. So I'm just creating this line. I'm not perfect with eyeliner, so it does take me some time. And that's why I partially cut out most of my eyeliner, because it takes me a while to perfect that line for it to be nice and neat and sharp. So I just keep going back and forth till I get it right. Using my Lash Paradise mascara, this is most definitely the dupe for the Better Than Sex mascara, if you didn't hear in one of my last videos. And these are the lashes I'm using, Beauty Supply Store lashes. I look for something wispy with a little bit of spacing when I want like a more dramatic like eyelash. So now I decided, okay, it was not deep and black enough. And this is what I was talking about when I said, like, you can go back in with the black and smoke it out a little bit more. You have the opportunity to darken it as much as you want at this point. and you kind of get like some control when you do that. So I'm using a blender brush and I'm just like packing that black in until I feel like it's smoked out enough, and I'm just bringing it towards the blue. I want the blue to kind of like gradually go into the black a little bit more, so I'm just going to keep blending until I feel like I have it. This eyeshadow look is one for the bugs. The colors came out perfect. I want to say thank you for everyone that came on and that supported to watch this video and took the time out to do that. Like, I'm so appreciative for every single viewer that I have, and the time that you take for me is just like, it means a lot to me. So go over to my Instagram. I post many little vlogs in my stories, and I post multiple pictures of this look, and you can see my upcoming looks for next time.